is a presentation of TFNN. The Tom O'Brien Show is produced every business day. Tom takes your phone calls toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Oh, it's a beautiful thing. Look at our man, Jim from Minneapolis. We gonna take it by storm?
Taking it by storm, baby.
I love that. That's a great saying, man. Hey, what's happening, brother?
Good morning, gentlemen. How you guys doing today?
Good, man. Yourself?
Oh, man. It's been the most incredible couple of days since when I called in on Friday, Litecoin busted out of that consolidation on the two-hour chart.
Okay.
And it just never looked back. It did a 100-point ABC up, and now it's very extended the way I look at it. But
yeah.
I mean, it went up to $420 last night.
Now, Tom O'Brien.
Welcome, folks. This is Tom O'Brien of TFNN. We go 5 days a week. We go 7 hours a day. We go 24 hours a day on the internet at TFNN.com. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. Hope everyone's having a great day, safe day. Let's make it a great night, folks. Create the perfect relationship between you and your body. Treat your body with all love, honor, gratitude, and respect. When you're making a goal to adore your body and accept yourself completely, you learn to have the perfect relationship with anyone else you are with. Marketwise, let's take a look at it out here. We have the Dow Industrials up 206. NASDAQ is up 53. S&P's up 23. Gold contract down $1.20, trading at $14.73 an ounce. We got silver up 16 cents, $17.01 an ounce. Light sweet crude up 57 cents, $59.32 a barrel. Notes and bonds, we got the 10-year. Down 29 ticks, 128.12. 30-year off full point, 2 points plus 6 ticks at 156.24. And King Dollar. King Dollar up 216 ticks, trading 97.334. The Euro is at 111. The Yen is at 109.36. And the Pound is at 131 to 1 U.S. dollar. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. Give us a call, folks. Want to know what's going on in your world? Well, first, let's go to the world of the tariffs, the trade system, the whole ball of wax. And what we're looking at right here, supposedly right now, what's happening, folks, is that you get Trump at the White House meeting with his staff. That started at 2:30. Bottom line, they say things are in place, that this thing's going to get signed. And Trump came out this morning and did a tweet that, you know, the deal was going to, big deal is coming. That shot the S&Ps up in an incredible way. So we'll see how this comes into the close. They started the meeting at 2:30 this afternoon. Now, there's so many things happening, folks. One of the biggest things that just came across the tape, though, now this is a monster, too. So check this out. This is pretty intense. We're talking about, you're coming to the end of the year, you're talking about the repo market, right? Well, the Federal Reserve has come out the last, it was about the last 6 or 7 weeks, and they have basically... First, you know, this had started out as the overnight repo market, folks. Then the Federal Reserve has extended the repo market to 32 days. Now, when they had done that, they were still talking, well, they were talking about giving $25 billion. And the last two times that as the banks came into it, it was oversubscribed. It was $45 billion. I had said at that point, guess what, man? They got to do something about it because that's saying... that this has to be, that the banks need cash coming into the end of the year because what happens, bottom line, is that this is leverage all over the place. That's what it is, okay? So check it out. Coming across the tape just now, you're going to love this figure. The Fed plans $365 billion in repo operations to get through January, okay? So that just came across the deal. That, folks, is one monster deal. It's surprising to me. Now, this just happened right when I came on the air, but it's actually surprising to me that that's not spooking the bond market a bit because we know that Federal Reserve came out yesterday with the statement. If you listen to Powell, bottom line, there's no two ways. It was dovish beyond belief. This number here is telling me it's not only just dovish, but this number here is telling me that, guess what? We know there's a lot of cash in the system, But this is saying that the banks, man, are leveraged to the hilt. I mean, to the hilt, because the bottom line is that that's what it is. That's at the end of the day, every day, that's what the repo market does. They balance your books and say, okay, are you ready for business the next day? Well, guess what? They're going to have plenty of money now to be ready for business. Gold contract out here. What do we have with gold? You know, you had gold much higher before the tweet come out, gives it up on price. Guess what, though? You get monster volume. We took out the swing point, took it out with volume. Each and every time this happens, you go right back topside. You go after it again. You know, this is like a broken record. I said the exact same thing last week. Last week, what we did, we got to 1489. You had 320,000 contracts. Gave it up on price. Comes back down to 1463. Guess what? We got over that today, 1491. You get monster volume, too. You get 389,000 contracts already. So bottom line, what I expect, we're going to be right back up into those higher numbers. We get over and we take a look at the silver market. Silver actually has held some price. Silver got to a price point today of 1718. Also huge volume, 109,000 contracts inside the silver market. Bottom line, silver is always higher volatility. There's no doubt about that. And, you know, silver's holding on price a bit better also than gold is. Right now, you're up 17 cents. Now, notes and bonds. Here we go. So, they hit the note and bond market approximately last time they really hit it was, on the November 7th. We, right now, are down 28 ticks in the 10-year, which is a big number. You're at 2.3 million contracts, which is a huge number. However, with that being said, you're going into a huge number from November 7th. Now, the low of November 7th in the 10-year is 127.30. We haven't got to it. We got to 128.05 or 128.12. I suspect coming into a Friday, yeah, we may test it. But if this goes right after it, right away, without building cars, it won't break it. You know, it could break it, but it'll reject it. That's how these things shake out, meaning that if it's too fast and too furious before the lower swing that it's going after, it uses all its energy up before it gets to the lower swing. If we go take a look at the 30-year set up the same way, big volume out here today, 531,000 contracts. You're down 2 points and three ticks. You're trading out at 156.26. Now, this one's going to be really tough to get to because that's 155. That'd be saying like we're going to down another 2 points. Right? We'll see if that's the case. There's going to be a lot of moving parts in this baby, there's no doubt. And if we go over to the dollar still looks to me like it's not going to hold price. What we have with the dollar yesterday, dollar goes south yesterday, breaks your swing points, does it with conviction, had the wide price spread out here. We went from 97.596 down to the 97.03. Right now, we bounce back today. We're at 97.332. We were as high as 519. You know, we'll see how this shakes out. That's telling me, though, now we're going to start building cars. We're going to start building cars to get down to the lows that were established in June and inside the dollar, and that's 95.843. Stay right there, folks. Come right back. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. Come right back.
The TFNN Tiger Dollar Holiday Sale is back. For 2 weeks only, we're offering the largest bonuses of the year on all Tiger Dollar purchases. Normally, you can get a 10 to 20% bonus on your purchase, but for the Tiger Dollar Holiday Special, we've doubled the normal bonuses where you can now get up to a 20, 30, or even a 40% bonus on your Tiger Dollar purchase. Tiger Dollars can be used for all TFNN newsletters, products, or services, are fully transferable, and never expire. If you're a current TFNN newsletter subscriber, then this is a great time to buy Tiger Dollars and apply them to all your future transactions for instant added savings. And if you're considering signing up for any TFNN newsletters, webinars, or products in 2020, then get up to a 40% bonus now before this sale ends Sunday, December 22nd. For all the details and to purchase your Tiger Dollars with up to a 40% bonus, visit the front page of TFNN.com today. If you're a trader in the market looking for exposure to gold or gold mining equities, then now is a perfect time to sign up for Tom O'Brien's Gold Report. The summer is over, gold is trading back above $1,500, and the 10-year treasury is hovering at around 1.5%. Tom O'Brien has been writing his weekly gold report for almost 18 years. There's no one that knows more about how the gold market trades and how gold mining equities react. New subscribers get a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have nothing to lose. Every Monday morning, Tom publishes his weekly gold report with coverage of gold, silver, bonds, the XAU, HUI, GDX, the dollar, as well as more than 30 different mining equities. As of September 3rd, Gold Report subscribers have 5 active open positions with an average unrealized profit of almost 38% for each position. To see for yourself the types of profitable trades that are recommended within the Gold Report, sign up today by visiting TFNN.com.
Many of our new listeners have heard about The Tiger's Den. The Tiger's Den is a lively community where professional traders and investors can meet, exchange ideas and information in a comfortable, moderated atmosphere, hear all of the TFNN shows, plus see all of the charts as they happen live, and have access to archives of all of those charts. You can test drive The Tiger's Den absolutely free for 30 days and greatly enrich your knowledge of these markets and how to make your money work for you. Details on The Tiger's Den are on the front page of TFNN.com.
TFNN has launched our brand new website. You can still visit us at the same TFNN.com URL, but when you do, you'll see a new and improved homepage with a much simpler navigation, whether you're watching Tiger TV live in high definition or just accessing your newsletter subscriptions. We even have new pricing in 6 months and yearly options. Check out the new TFNN.com now and experience all the upgrades. TFNN.com, educating investors.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Welcome back, folks. Dow is up 200, Nasdaq's up 46, S&Ps are up 23. Let's go take a look at inside the Index 100 as well as the Dow Industrials, the strength versus the weakness out here. So inside the Index 100, this is a monster, and this has to do, no doubt, I suspect, with the trade deal with China. You got Wynn. Wynn Resorts is up 9% or 1078. Now, Wynn Resorts, folks, okay, when you talk about the amount of revenue that they get out of Macau, China, it's just, it's hard to comprehend, actually. You know, you know that they're huge in Vegas, but when you break this revenue down, you're going to see this year they're taking in $6.7 billion. Well, 5.1 of that 6.7 is out of Macau. Only 1.7 on Vegas. It's pretty intense, actually, when you take a look at those numbers. AMD. AMD is up 6.5%. You got Western Digital is up 5%. And you get Trip.com. That's getting some life. That's up 3.1. Taken away from it on the way down. Lululemon is down 4.3%. You got Workday off 3%. Facebook is off 3%, and Align Technology is off 3%. Let's go take a look at Lululemon for a bit and see what's happening there. So they come in with numbers. Bottom line is, this is going to be interesting, man. This is volume off the high. So you made a high yesterday with 1.4. You're at 2.1 right now. And let's see, get this back quick. I know that the numbers were a little light of what they were looking for, but the bottom line is that they still came with some killer numbers. So for the year, they had, I see what's going on. So for the year, they had an estimate of 475. Now they see 475 to 478. So that's not bad. It's 96 cents this year versus 71 last year. Their gross margin is 55%. Their operating margin is 19. That's a huge number in gross margin. No two ways about that. Third quarter was they expected 93 cents. They came with 96. So bottom line is that they hit the numbers. But guess what? When you're trading at those high values, you got to basically get a higher value out there, higher growth. Inside the Dow Industrials, strength versus the weakness inside the Dow. We have Goldman Sachs is the leader, putting 34 positive points. J.P. Morgan, 27. Caterpillar, 17. United Health, 16. Taken away from it. The only stock that is taken away from it, well, there's two of them. Inside the Dow Industrials, you get Boeing, that's it, putting in a negative 34 points, and Apple, a negative 2.5. Apple's had quite a pull today between the bulls and the bears, folks. Big numbers here. You know, we take a look at it. Apple, you got a low out here today of 267.32. The high is 272.56. We're laying at 270.31 right now. And the all-time high is 271. So bottom line, you did make another all-time high today. Right now, we're basically just under that all-time high. But I can see why Apple would be in play in a big way, because the numbers in Apple, if in fact the tariffs had gone on this coming Sunday, they were going to get tagged at $150 per phone. That's one number, man. That is one monster number. No two ways about it. Some of the higher volume equities out here today, and this still looks like it's going to be a low volume market unless something happens in the next 35, 40 minutes. You have GE's up 58. That caught a bid. You get Chesapeake Energy. That's up 5. We get Bank of America up a buck. We'll check that out. Freeport MacMoran, that's still on the run. It's up to this 14.27 area. Right now, you're up 23 cents, trading 13.07. You get Intel up 37 cents. Facebook is down $6. So what's hitting Facebook here? Let's see. Okay, so FB. Well, let's get some juice underneath it. Okay, so let's see what they're saying here. This is going to be... Okay, so federal officials are considering seeking a preliminary injunction against Facebook over antitrust concerns related to how it produces, how its products interact, according to people familiar with the matter. If it materializes, the action by the Federal Trade Commission would focus on Facebook's policy concerning how it integrates its apps and allows them to work with potential rivals. Alongside its core social network, Facebook's key products also include Instagram, Messenger, and WhatsApp. Yeah, there's no doubt about it. If they're going to try to get, that's interesting, man. They're going to try to get an injunction right now. Now, what gets interesting there is that this antitrust is going to get serious. That's the way that baby looks. You know, if they try to get an injunction first, they take it apart by injunctions rather than a suit. It'd be pretty interesting, man. It's going to be pretty hard for the, I suspect, for the government to get an injunction and to stop business prior to a full-blown suit and a trial, you know, because what ends up happening there, folks, is that every time someone's going after someone, that the real question is going to be, you know, what is the harm to the company? I'm not sticking up for Facebook. I'm just trying to explain what the lawyers are going to say, is that the harm to the company can be more than the aspect of, okay, you're saying who's going to get hurt? Well, the company's going to say they're going to get hurt when, in fact, you know, the bottom line, they haven't proved anything yet. They're just saying that they don't like how they interact. Well, they definitely, we know if you're on any of those devices, folks, they interact, and they definitely interact in a huge way. 877-927-6648. Amazon, you know, bottom line, this is still a consolidation inside Amazon, and it's a low-level consolidation. This is like wild, man, because, you know, there's no doubt Amazon, you know, is a monster, but the way this is still trading out here, Amazon still looks like it's going to go down to 1672 when you get the market at all-time highs. We get over and we take a look at the GDX inside the gold market. You know, they whacked gold. Gold couldn't hold price today, but as I said earlier, it had plenty of volume up there. Bottom line, same thing with the equities. The equities, you know, you're down 12 cents right now, but guess what? You're actually going after the top of the range, and we will have volume. You know, yesterday they put volume in this. We had 76 million. Last swing point was 81. Right now you're at 35. I don't think you get 76 million in that today, but yesterday I forgot to check. Because what happens, folks, if you're trading this GDX, you definitely want to check at the end of every day. You want to see, you want to see what the volume is, but you really want to see before the fact, like right 2 or 3 minutes before 4, how much volume is in it. then how much they put in at the close. Because as they're putting it at the close, what they're doing is that they're going to the net asset value. As they go to the net asset value, they have to spread that across all the weighting structures that's inside the GDX, and it gives you a real good feeling, okay, of how the equity is either pushing with volume or contracting with volume as it's going up. If it's contracting with volume, it's going up, and they don't have that push at the end, guess what? That's when you want to pull back. As you're going downtown, it's just the opposite. That's why you want to basically have that number and know what that number is. And you know what the number is, okay? The bottom line is that the only way that you can do that, though, is by paying attention right at the close and then bringing it up quickly so that you can see what that number was at coming into the close. Stay right there, folks. Come right back. Dow Industrials up 211, NASDAQ up 53, S&P's up 24. Come right back.
If you're not currently using the TAS Profile Scanner when looking at setting up your trading opportunities, then your arsenal is short a mighty weapon. The TAS Profile Scanner is a standalone piece of software that instantly filters over 2,500 global financial markets such as stocks, ETFs, commodity futures, and Forex. Headed by Steve Dahl, TAS understands that in today's technological world, the use of top-flight software applications and technical analysis expertise is essential to successful trading in today's market. You also gain access to the webinar that Steve Dahl and Tom O'Brien just hosted, The Best Way to Use the TAS Profile Scanner to Profit. This webinar archive is available for all subscribers immediately upon signing up. All new subscriptions also come with a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have nothing to risk. Start your subscription by visiting the front page of TFNN.com today, and you'll find the TAS Profile Scanner under the Services tab. Sign up today. Are you in the market for buying or selling real estate in the Bay Area, including the surrounding St. Petersburg, Tampa, and Clearwater markets? Tiger Real Estate LLC is a firm that has extensive experience in the Tampa Bay Area. Whether you're looking to sell your current property for maximum value, or you're in the market for a second home or investment property, Tiger Realty has the experience across all areas of real estate in the Tampa Bay area to help buyers and sellers make the most informed decisions across all price levels. From the price you should be paying per square foot in certain up-and-coming areas to the type of cash flow investment properties are capable of creating, Tiger Real Estate can help you make the best decision when it comes to all areas of the market. Before you make one of the biggest decisions of your financial future, call Tiger Real Estate LLC today at 727-329-8322 or email us at tiger@tfnn.com. That's 727-329-8322. Call us today. TFNN has put together the best lineup of live content for traders by traders every market day, featuring some of the most knowledgeable and respected minds in the business. TFNN broadcasts 5 days a week live from 9 a.m. until 5 p.m. Eastern Time. We have live programming every market day during market hours. Every morning, Larry Pesavento kicks off the trading day live at 9 a.m. and breaks down the opening bell with Trade What You See. At 10 a.m., Tom and Tommy O'Brien host the TFNN Bull Bear Trading Hour, followed at 11 a.m. by the team at TD Ameritrade and Thinkorswim with Fast Market. Basil Chapman hosts the Tiger Technicians Hour at noon, Steve Rhodes at 1 p.m. with the Trader's Edge, Dave White at 2 p.m. with the Power Trading Hour, and Tom O'Brien anchors the daily lineup from 3 till 5 as host of the Tom O'Brien Show. Tune in to TFNN's Tiger TV on your computer or mobile device, and you can always find us streaming on YouTube. TFNN.com, educating investors.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Welcome back, folks. Dow's up 228, NASDAQ's up 57, S&P's are up 25. And let's see what we got here. So let's go back into this repo for a second, because this is pretty amazing, actually. So they just got more news on it coming across. So let's see how they're going to do this. So the Federal Reserve is now going to conduct operations totaling $365 billion. The December 16th operation will be today's December 12th. Okay, so 13th, 14th. Okay, so Tuesday. It's going to be 32-day offering with a maximum of $50 billion, while the other term auctions are going to range from 13 to 15 days with a maximum of $35 billion. Okay, so there's going to be a total, I think, what did I say, $365 billion. Okay, now here's some of them. The central bank also plans to adjust the size of some of its overnight repo operations to provide additional liquidity for year-end. While the offering size will remain mostly unchanged at $120 billion, it plans to conduct a one-day forward settlement operation of $75 billion on December 30th that settles on the 31st and matures on the 2nd of January. The New York Fed is also going to increase the sizes of their overnight auctions to $150 billion on December 31st and the January 2nd. The Fed has been conducting repo operations and treasury bill purchases and bid to keep control of the short-term interest rate and bolster bank reserves. Yeah, forget the interest rate, folks. The bottom line is that this, so picture this, folks. This is how I just want you to understand, like, kind of how this works. So picture that you just have your own household budget, okay? And in your household budget, you have bills that have to be due on the 31st, okay? And you have certain regulations that you need to have so much money that is in reserve versus what you have done all year long. Meaning, like, let's say all year long, let's just use $100, okay? To make it easy. Just use $100. We use $100 and say that's our budget, right? And then what ended up happening is that, you know, you get $10 invested here, 10 here, 20 there, 40 there, 10 there. Now that gets us $90, okay? That gets us $10 left. Now, what ends up happening is that what this is saying here, and so your investments, if they're in liquidity, that's great. But what ends up happening is that they have to be on your balance sheet in cash. There has to be so much cash, and then there can be so many securities. Well, what this is saying right here is that the banks could very well have plenty of bread, and I'm sure they do, but they don't have liquidity. They don't have the liquidity, and that's what this is all about. This is where they're, if we all, and you know, when I started the gold report in 2001, the gold bugs, of course, are over this on a continual basis, and the aspect of if we all went and wanted our money out of the bank, it would be a monster problem, because guess what? It's not there. You know, it's there, but guess what? It's already used something else. It's leveraged for something else, and that's how this shakes out. And the Fed thus far has been very good at the public relations aspect, you know, behind this, because people ask questions, well, what is the problem? They're claiming there's not a problem. Well, guess what? And I'll bring it back to our own household. If you don't have the money at the end of the month or when the bill is due, you don't have the cash. Is it a problem or not a problem? And that's what this is right here. The thing that's amazing about this one is that, and you know, I was talking about this last week, that for the amount of bids that were going into the repo operation versus what the Fed was giving, the Fed wasn't giving enough, and you could see it, okay? Bottom line, in this particular case, though, you can see they're piling it up, $365 billion, you know, in a huge way. So just as that press conference yesterday was dovish, this sign here would be the, well, listen, they got to keep the system going. There's no doubt about that. I'm not saying not doing it. What I'm saying is that you just want to make sure you understand what that means. And what that means is that the banks have leveraged themselves to the hilt again. That's what it means. And they have products inside there that, yeah, you know, the way that banks move, folks, the bottom line is that's, you know, You have a situation, number one, that you have, they get an interest on something that they don't even own, meaning money, because they can leverage that out. So it totally makes sense if that's the name of the game anyway. Well, you're going to make sure that you get every penny out of it. So that's how they're set up. You know, if we look at Bank of America today, look at this. It's breaking out. That's up $1.07. We're at $34.70. Yeah, it's breaking out of this consolidation. Let me see this. 33.05. We'll see if we get it on the monthly. This is going to be intriguing, man, because the bottom line is that this has been here for a long period of time. Bank of America is still trading as it was in 2008. But if they can get away from this area, then Bank of America could go to 55. Let me go see J.P. Morgan. J.P. Morgan's always been the strongest bank out here for a long period of time. That's breaking out. That's an ABC up, actually. You got, see if it's an ABC up on a weekly, too. Not on a weekly. You got a daily. It's at all-time highs. 135.78. Nothing big. Well, 7 points is big, actually. That gives you 139. We're almost there. But that's a monster breakout, too. And J.P. Morgan is at all-time highs, I believe. Yeah, it is. And if we go to the XLF, I suspect as... thanks, Jim. Yeah, it's a big breakout. Yeah. So bring this back. Put this on 10 years so we can see the setup from 08. Yep. So the XLF, $30.32 is the number. We're over it. Oh, look at this. Oh, this is interesting. 30.92. This is right next to its all-time high. Yeah, so this gets interesting because you have different weighting structures inside the XLF. And this is right next to its all-time high of $30.97. We hit 30.88. And BRK, that's going to be Berkshire, is the largest weighting and structure and equity inside this structure. And that's breaking out, too. That's up $3. All the banks are breaking out. Yep. And Berkshire, 223. This looks to me like this just also hit an all-time high today. Yep, today, 226. XLF, let me just see who the... So Berkshire is the biggest weighting. I think J.P. Morgan is next. Yeah, it is. So, oh, look at J.P. Morgan's 12%, too. So Berkshire Hathaway's 12.6% weighting. J.P. Morgan's 12.4%. Bank of America, 8.1%. Big numbers, man. 12.24%. Look at that. 33% of the XLF of free stocks. Come right back, folks.
If you're in the CD market and looking for a secure investment, the Tiger First Mortgage Program may work for you. The security for these first mortgages are building lots in the Tax Opportunity Zone in St. Petersburg, Florida. The Tax Act of 2018 set up tax-free zones across the country where you can build and hold for 10 years and pay no tax on the profits, which makes these lots valuable. The investment is anywhere from $30,000 to $75,000. The interest paid is 7% yearly, paid on a monthly basis. According to Bankrate.com, the best rate for a four-year CD in the country as of February 20th is 3.1%. A $50,000 investment at a normal four-year CD rate of 3.1% would give you income of $1,550 per year or $6,200 over the four-year period. That same $50,000 investment in the Tiger First Mortgage Program would give you $3,500 per year or $14,000 over the 4 years. Which would you prefer, $6,200 or $14,000 of interest on your investment? If you would like more information about the Tiger First Mortgage Program, you can call me at 877-518-9190. That's 877-518-9190.
The Path of Least Resistance is David White's daily trading newsletter, and if you're looking for active trading ideas, then now's a perfect time for a 30-day free trial to this powerful daily trading advisory service. David uses his years of trading experience to offer his subscribers his trading ideas each morning in his Path of Least Resistance newsletter. Using a combination of equity trades along with options, David keeps his subscribers up to date with all pertinent market information with intraday afternoon updates when warranted. Don't miss out on this great chance to get a 30-day free trial to David's daily newsletter, The Path of Least Resistance, with no obligation to pay anything. David has been delivering solid recommendations for his subscribers recently, and if you'd like to see the type of newsletter he delivers every morning, then visit the front page of TFNN, and you'll find The Path of Least Resistance under Trading Newsletters. For all the details and to start your 30-day free trial today, log on to TFNN.com now. Biotech is booming, but for how long? Whether you think the biotech bull has room to run or has run its course, trade LABU or LABD. Direction's daily S&P Biotech 3x bull and bear ETFs. Visit directioninvestments.com/biotech today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Tom O'Brien.
Welcome back, folks. Dow up 230, NASDAQ up 58, S&P's up 26. Let's go over. So check this out. Lyft just announced, folks, that it's going to announce that they now have a rental car service with unlimited miles for selected users in the Bay Area. That's San Francisco and Los Angeles. And if you want to see what that does to Hertz and Avis intraday, how quick it does it, it's pretty intense, folks. So this just got announced 20 minutes ago. You just had Avis go from $33 down to $30.98. Let's see what this is looking like. Man, these companies just totally make sense. It's like, okay, they're in the car business, really. Yeah. So this has been a consolidation, low-end consolidation, since 2015. This thing wants to go back into $20.71. Right now, you're at $30.94. So HTZ, let's go look at Hertz, see what happened to Hertz out here. 85 cents, not the end of the world, except that that's only a $15 stock. And that went from $16.65 down to $15.17. And this is a mess also, there's no doubt. Let's take a look at this. Oh, yeah. Well, this Hertz is really a mess. So Hertz is down from 2014 to $109. Makes a low of $7.40. Does a bounce to 23, never takes. Now, if you want to see something that you can get volume in, folks, right? I've talked about this a few different times. You're coming off the bottom, you get volume in it, but you don't get to the swing point. That's crucial. That really wrap your head around. This is a setup like that. It came off the bottom at $7, had volume as it went up all the way to 18.5, but guess what? Never even got to a swing, and then bottom line just gave it up again from $23 down to $15. And yeah, this is game to go test $11 again. And LYFT, let's see what just happened with Lyft, if they got a Lyft or what they did. So that's trading down 69 cents, no big deal there. It didn't move Lyft, you know. But bottom line is that you can see. If, in fact, you're going to have Lyft get into the car rental business, Uber getting in the car rental business, well, because we know what they have already done. They have those car purchase programs, folks, that are pretty wild, meaning that you're working for them, you buy the car, they buy the car for you. Bottom line, you pay it off. Now, the next thing is that, hey, they're saying, hey, guess what? If the cars aren't being used, the next thing I can picture that, yeah, you could definitely picture this. So picture this. You have the cars. You rent the cars. But when they're not renting the cars, it's going to be like the airline seats. They get so efficient at selling the airline seats and selling, you know, every part of the airline, I mean, where you put your baggage and everything else, these car rental companies, I expect, could get the exact same way, meaning keep the car going 24 hours a day. Here's the pickup. Here's the drop-off. Get it in. Get it out. Another way of basically cutting down with a huge amount of expenses. There's no doubt about that. Oil. Let's go over to the oil market. We had with oil out here. Oil is laying right at the $60 level. We hit $59.72 out here today. This has been bottom line, try to crawl up to the last swing high out here, $61.48. What we did yesterday is that you came out with the API numbers come out. Bottom line, they were bottom line, big numbers, meaning plenty of oil. Oil first shot down to 58 and then said, see ya, don't want to be a, so it looks to me like this is wanting to test that 61.48 area. If we go over to the Exxon Mobil and we take a look at Exxon, you know, that's catching a small bid today. These have been a mess. Exxon and Chevron have been a mess. There's no two ways about it. Catching a bid out here today up at about $1.37, you know, and we'll see whether it can hold $70.15. Chevron, same type of setup. Chevron wrote off huge, almost $12 billion they wrote off inside their natural gas business. Yesterday, bottom line, you know, Chevron right now is up $2.50. Last swing out here is at $1.19. Right now you're at $118.88. So coming out after the close, I believe Costco is going to have numbers after the close. Let's see what they're looking for. Costco, yeah, that's going to be at the 12th. Yeah, it's the 12th. So Costco is trading up $2 right now. We're at $297.38. Costco is going to be looking to bring to the top line $37.3 billion. And to the bottom line, $1.72. Let me just make sure of something here. Yeah. Bottom line is almost trading like it already came out. So what you have with Costco, Costco wants higher price. So you get a, Costco has a high volume high out here at 307. 307.34. Let me see if that is the high. Yeah, it is. What a run this is. Look at this. Just brought this back to 2010. 2010, $47 to 297. There's no doubt that there is a huge amount of profit these last 7, 8, 9 years. The real question is, they take it off the table, just roll with it. We go to Walmart. Walmart, you know, bottom line, also hanging at highs, 119. Now, Walmart has spiked at a 125, but gave it up that same day. And Target, TG, you know, Target as well as Walmart have been hanging at these highs. Yeah, Target up $1.43 today. That's going after its high again of 127.95. And Amazon's the dog out here that just can't seem to get it going. So it's going to be really intriguing to find out after the Christmas holiday just what, you know, the problem is. Adobe, ADBE. Adobe's going to be coming out with numbers also after the close. That's going to be, so the low's 203, the high's 313. Right now you're at 305. And let's see what we have here. Well, she's pressing against highs, that's for sure. Interesting, though. She came down off the high with 14 million. That's 311. You press with 9 million. You press with 7. We'll get 9. They go into 14. It's going to be hard for Adobe to basically get up into that high. We're right next to it, but there's still not enough juice there. I kind of lost the juice when it got to 293. So that'll be an intriguing one to see how that baby shakes out. So with Costco, I would say that, yeah, it's going to go for the all-time high. With Adobe, no. Adobe looks to me like you're going to basically pull back a bit. That's how that seems to be setting up right now. Dow Industrials right now, we are trading up 249, NASDAQ up 68, S&Ps are up 24. We get over and we take a look at that E-mini S&P. What you're going to see out here is that the high for today is 31.77. And guess what, folks? They're going to go for it. We're right at 31.73. It's not going to be much to basically get up into and basically close at those all-time highs. Stay right there, folks. Come right back.
I'm certain you are or strive to be one of the best of the best at everything you do in life. It's the most common trait that we tigers and tigresses share. If you're looking to become the best of the best when it comes to managing your money, let me teach you to do what most wealth managers tell you can't be done, which is how to time the markets. I'm Steve Rhodes, author of Mastering Probability, and for the last 12 months, Timer Digest has been tracking my newsletter signals, which have earned me the ranking as their number one market timer in the nation for the S&P 500 for the last 12, 6, and 3 months. Timer Digest also ranks me as the number one market timer for gold as well. The fact is, markets can be timed, and I'll teach you the exact set of tools that I use that has transformed me into one of the best at what I do. Sign up for Mastering Probability today by clicking on the newsletter tab on the homepage of TFNN.com and get immediate access to workshops where I take you step by step how to use an extraordinary set of tools as well as provide great market calls too. Sign up today.
Since 1984, Basil Chapman has been using the Chapman Wave methodology to advise traders of his expert market opinion. While originally hand-drawing charts from the late 1970s into the 1980s, Basil noticed that prices under most circumstances virtually always had a certain number of legs to the upside before declining sharply. Later, Basil found that computer software, which included the standard market technical indicators, enhanced the degree of accuracy in calling price turns as well as market trend calls. Thus was born the Chapman Wave sequence. Using the Chapman Wave methodology along with other indicators, Basil Chapman advises his subscribers of his expert market opinion each market day with his opening call newsletter. Right now, you can get a two-week free trial to the opening call, Basil's daily trading newsletter, by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Cancel at any time during that trial and pay absolutely nothing. Get your two-week free trial to Basil's newsletter, the opening call, today by visiting TFNN.com.
You know what's cool? Taking something that's good for you. Something specifically formulated to help with weight loss, better sleep, stress reduction, and the need to detox.
Nico, our hunter and gatherer ancestors found all their nutritional requirements for health in their wild environment. But today, our food sources no longer contain the vitamins, minerals, and nutrients our bodies need to stay healthy and strong.
That's why we need Primal Edge Daily Nutrition. It includes a special blend of ionic, soil-based vitamins, minerals, fatty, and amino acids in an easy-to-use liquid form.
Primal Edge is powered by highly concentrated folic and humic acids, nature's preferred delivery system. They have been called miracle molecules because, like sunlight, air, and water, life cannot exist without them.
That's right, Paige. They ensure we receive all the nutrition we need to be healthy and thrive.
We take it every morning.
Primal Edge, formulated and approved by Nico and Paige of Living a Primal Lifestyle. Buy it today for just $89. Click on the Primal Edge banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Don't forget, you can listen to TFNN live on your mobile device 24 hours per day. Go to TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV. That's TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV for the latest market information.
Welcome back, folks. Dow's up 255, NASDAQ is up 72, S&Ps are up 30. Looks like they're going to finish at all-time highs, folks. They run it right into the close. And, folks, as you come over to our website at TFNN, right under featured content, you're going to see the Tiger Dollar Sale. Now, we do this a couple times a year. This one happens to be, we double the bonuses. What Tiger Dollars are, they're good for all product at TFNN. No expiration date, totally transferable. So if you have subscriptions at TFNN right now, it's a great way to save a large amount of money. And you can get three different Tiger Dollar promotions. The first one is you buy $500, you get an additional $100 or $600, which is a 20% bonus. You can get $1,000, you get an additional $300 or $1,300, a 30% bonus, and the max is you can buy $1,500, and that gets you a $600 bonus at $2,100, which is a 40% bonus. Check it out on the front page of TFNN. This is only good until next Sunday, so bottom line, check it out. Market-wise out here, bottom line is that all these indices, the ETF structures, when we're talking the SPY, we're talking the NDX 100, Dow, all-time highs, small caps, bottom line, small caps still lagging. Inside the SPY, and it's pushing away from this high in a big way. Last high up here in the SPY was 315.48, and you are at 317.34. So you're not only pushed away from it, but you're pushing away from it with conviction, meaning when you get wide price spread, folks, and you get away from the high that you're taking out, the probability is higher that you can go higher, a lot higher, too. When we take a look at the NDX 100. Now, this was failing a little bit earlier. Bottom line, it roared back. 206.05 is the number. Bottom line, you're 206.72. And, of course, the Dow Industrials, that one also, that is, oh, that one's interesting, actually. That one, 28,174. So this one actually couldn't hold price. Pretty wild. So the Dow's the only one that couldn't hold price. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. And whatever you want in life, folks, visualize it like a nice big motion picture. Step into it, take ownership of it, and fly with it. Thanks for being here, folks. Have a great night, safe night. And we look forward to speaking to you right back here tomorrow morning. Come join Larry. He kicks us off 9 o'clock in the morning. Whew! Look at it, folks.